Dixon with the mustache jumping across the fucking screen, that kind of shit. Sweet. I got some nerves. Because life is like Mario. So I was out to dinner with this girl the other night, right? This girl was like beautiful. And not just beautiful, like she was juicy. Like this girl was sweet, but just sour enough that she keeps it coming back for more. You know what I mean? And we're having this conversation. In the middle of it, she stops and she's like, look at that ugly fucking painting up on the wall. And I look and sure enough, there it is, up on the wall, an ugly painting of flowers. And she's like, how could so many people gotta paint pictures of flowers? Like everybody has never done it 100 times before. Ha! And I'm like, ha! But really, the whole time I'm thinking, the whole reason why so many people gotta paint pictures of flowers is because all the truly beautiful people in this world, like yourself, never stand still long enough to actually paint a picture of. So you have to settle for the flowers. But I don't say that, right? Good thing, too, because then she starts talking about her boyfriend. She's like, he's really sweet and nice and everything like that. He treats you really good, but there's just like this other guy in my life that's just like adorable and stuff. Like, I really think I'm in love, and I don't know how to feel. Like, really, really confused. I'm like, listen, shut up. Your whole problem is you don't want to hurt your boyfriend's feelings because of how much he likes you. And at the same time, you're also afraid this other guy, he just might be like a get-rich-quick scheme and stuff. Like, he ain't worth all the hassle. And she's like, wow, it's like at a totally different level of consciousness to me. And I'm like, what? And she's like, listen. Life is like a building, or race, or building with levels. Everybody's trying to get to the same floor to learn the same thing. I'm like, no. Life ain't like that. Life ain't that linear. Life is more round than that. Life is like your plate of food. You got your corn and your potatoes and your steaks, right? And this guy right over here, he knows what the corn tastes like, right? And this lady right here, she knows what the potatoes taste like, but not the corn. Why? Because she hasn't eaten that shit yet. She hasn't made that decision in life yet. And the meat is like that juicy, chewy, sloppy part of life that some people just don't want to deal with because, like, what if he's a vegetarian? You don't want to deal with that sloppy ass shit, so you gotta move it off your plate so it's not to be sloppy yourself. You gotta grab a napkin and wipe up all that excess juice. And that napkin, that's like an outside source. That's like religion, philosophy, self-help books, your favorite freaking TV show. Anything that you can use to help deal with that stuff that you don't really want to deal with, but really, life ain't like a plate of food. Life is like Mario Brothers. And not Mario Brothers 2, 3, 4, Super 64, none of that shit. Old school Mario Brothers 1. Why? Because you can't go back. Taking the safe route to the end, she's warping. Y'all remember level 1-2 when you can jump over the bricks in the end? And there's three little pipes back there? From there, you go to 4-4, you go to 4-3, from 5-3, you go to 8, from 8, you go to, you get to the end of the whole goddamn game. But in the meantime, you're missing all this stuff. All these levels that you should be experiencing with this other guy, she's getting greedy, she's going down pipes. And y'all know when you go down pipes, you get those golden flashy, rich coins at the bottom. But when you come up on the other side, you still miss like 7 or 8 more screens. More shit like that this girl should be taking care of. And by not taking care of it, she's getting confused. So what she really needs to do is start over. She needs to turn the game off, hit eject, pull the cartridge out, blow it, stick it back in, and start over. She needs to hit reset and start over. And if she's gonna start over, then why not start over with me? Thank you. Even after you leave me, I still love you. It's not funny, motherfuckers. I climbed to Gans like a six-year-old climbs a tree. Fell off, hit my head, blacked out, woke up, and in my delirium, I mistook my concussion for being in love with you. You see, loving you is like popping pimples, pinking scabs, watching Survivor, laughing at the kid with a stutter. You don't want to, but you just can't help yourself. Most of the time, I wasn't your lover so much as I was like your tool. I was like a fuzzy-faced vibrator that told jokes and gave you compliments. Let's review our history. First night, I saw you, you saw me, we both saw your best friend's bathroom. Thank God for common and saving relationships for over 60 years. On the second night, I introduced you to anal beads, bondage, cunnilingus is done extremely fucking good. Pay attention, this is an alphabetical order. Hog tying, inverted jaguars, was deemed too difficult for the final letter of the Kama Sutra, liquid latex, maple syrup, nipple clamps, power tools, quickies, role playing, spanking, toe sucking up, stroking out, using vanilla ice cream as a lubricant, not get yourself hurt. On the third night, I cut a maple open on the length of your naked body with a tonsil knife, hoping that the line of juice would seep into your pores and split you open from the inside out so I could finally see what it is that makes you tick. On the fourth night, I divisioned a mind of death in the flesh and blood beneath your belly button as you came. On the fifth night, I cut off my tongue and offered it to you as a sacrifice, praying that you would consume it and finally know how good it is that you taste on the inside. On the sixth night, you told me you loved me, and I let out a scream not heard since the mothers of the seventh plague. And on the seventh night, I realized that God is a man and Satan is a woman. Because only a man can create something so beautiful and then screw it up, and only a woman would decide to give up on his ass and just simply fuck with him for the rest of eternity. How about one more hate fuck? For old time's sake, one more pitch. I'll even let you do me. You've already screwed my emotions. Now how about my ass? I guess that's a little bit much to ask for. It's not like you've ever been a giver besides. You don't get me wet anymore, and I don't want to chafe. Fact. The human body, when broken down into its basic common elements, has a market value of around $5. The problem is the human soul ain't worth shit. And loving you is like getting over to pick up a quarter while taking a piss in the vendor's bathroom. It's just not worth the investment. And I respect. I have nothing left to give. I used to be the type of guy that kept his heart broken so that he gave the important parts to the people that mattered. But your greedy ass ate the whole motherfucking pomegranate. When I first met you, I was whiskey and AC/DC. At the end of our relationship, I was Yerba Mate and the Smiths. Well, bitch, God have no fury like an emo boy scorned. And cry my little eyes out, write 54 lonely love poems. But you know what? My tear ducts, they just went dry. And so has my fucking pen, but